Hello and welcome to the channel. I'm Ominous and today I will react to Spin's magazine. I believe it's Spin. Or it's All Access, I believe? I don't know. It's Guitar World's 100 Greatest Guitars of All Time. All Access just is sharing it, I guess. So there we go. I believe this is the list that Stevie T reacted to, you know, where Skrillex was on and stuff like that, but he, Skrillex isn't on here, so this is probably another list. You know, Stevie Young talked about it, but I forgot what he said, so there we go, because, you know, he has so much shit to say with so little meaning, in my opinion, so there we go. I'm so kind to my fans, aren't I? Fuck's sake. But yeah, I only have 20 minutes, so I'm, you know the drill with these lists. If I love the artist, I'm gonna talk about it. If I hate the artist, I'm gonna talk about them. If I'm in the middle, you know, I usually don't say anything. I just say the number and move on. If I don't know the artist, I'm just saying the number and move on. So let's, you know the drill with these lists. So let's go. Number 100 is Wes Montgomery. Never heard of him. Number 99 is John 5. I've heard of the guy. He was on Loudwire a few times. He is in. I believe he's the guitarist for Marilyn Manson. I'm not a huge fan of Marilyn Manson, so John 5 looks kind of like a douchebag to me. So fuck that guy. Number 98 is Derek Trucks, and the name to John 5 is retarded. I mean Maroon 5. You know, it reminds me of a bad band. So fuck you. Number 97 is Tosin Abasi. Number 96 is Mark Knopfler, of course, of Dire Straits. Not a huge fan of Dire Straits. Really repetitive, boring band. Speaking of repetitive, boring bands, number 95, Jack White. Guitars, of course, of the White Stripes. Not a huge fan of the White Stripes. I believe that Elephant was requested, but I don't give a shit anymore. You know, so fuck that. Fuck that noise. I don't hate the White Stripes. I just think they're really boring. So there we go. Number 94 is Albert King. Number 93 is Gary Rossington. Number 92 is Ace Frehley of Kiss, arguably one of the most overrated guitars ever. You know, Kiss being the most overrated band, arguably ever. I mean, Ace Frehley is a good guitarist. He can shred, he can play licks, you know, he is a good guitarist, but I don't think... You know, Kiss fans are fucking crazy. The Kiss army is retarded. Like, why are you guys worshipping fucking manchilds in face paint, in makeup? Like, who fucking cares, mate? Kiss music is mediocre as fuck. Number 91 is T-Bone Walker. That sounds retarded, honestly. Number 90 is Robin Trower. Number 89 is Kenny Wayne Shepherd. Sounds American as fuck, honestly. Probably is. Number 88 is Neil Young. I didn't know he played guitar. Yeah, I guess folk rock. He had that one song on the Stevie T video. It's such an incoherent solo, but sure, put him on there. And then right above that, Sinister Gate 87, like, sure, mate. I mean, Neil Young is a legend. What a Sinister Gate. He's like an emo shredder or something. I'm not a huge fan of A7X. Oh, I see what they did there. A7X, 87, A6, or A6, A7X. Nah, I see what they did there. That's retarded. Number 86 is Peter Frampton. Number 85 is Jeff Hanneman. A big fan of Slayer. Love Jeff. I believe that Kerry King is higher, or he wasn't on the list. But for my money, Jeff Hanneman is the fucking dude. I mean, come on now. He is the ultimate guitarist. Fuck Kerry King. Number 84 is Malcolm Young of AC/DC. Rest his soul. I believe he recently passed away. So, yeah. Rest in peace, Malcolm Young. Number 83 is Glenn Tipton of Judas Priest. Great guy, love him. I believe he recently had Alzheimer's, or not Alzheimer's, but he had a stroke or something, or he had a disease. So get better, mate. Join your Judas Priest mate, because recently you dropped a fucking banger of a record. I loved it all. So I mean, everybody does. So there we go. Number 81 is Nuno Bettencourt. Number 80 is KK Downing, also from Judas Priest. This guy retired. I love this guy too. He was a great, he was also a great guitarist, you know, just like Glenn Tipton. I would say they're equal to each other. KK Downing is, I think, a bit more iconic, but, you know, he recently quit the band, so. Rest of soul too, but he wasn't on fucking, firepower, which is kind of a shame, but you know, it's still pretty good. 79 is Gary Moore. Number 78 is Chris Broderick. I've heard these names, by the way, Gary Moore and Chris Broderick, but I can't quite put my finger on it. Number 77 is Andy Summers, who is of course from The Police. Honestly, Andy Summers is a really underwhelming guitarist for me. Like, he is pretty middle of the road for me. He's just alright to me, you know, he's just an alright guitarist. He does the trick. He's kind of like a Nick Mason, I suppose. He just, you know, he does the trick. He does what he needs to do. But he is the worst member of The Police. I mean, Sting pretty much writes everything from The Police, and Stuart Copeland is the greatest member, or you know, the best instrument player, because he is a great drummer. So there we go. Number 76 is Aldi Miola. That's a dumbass name. Number 75 is Joe Perry of Aerosmith, of course. Fucking hate Aerosmith. Joe Perry is an overrated hack, so fuck that guy. Number 74, you know, speaking of guys that I fucking hate, number 74 is Ted Nugent. You know, Joe Perry, do your thing, you know, you do you. Ted Nugent, literally fuck yourself, like fuck this guy. He's not one of the greatest guitars. He's such a average guy. I mean, come on now. One and wonder bloke. Rory Gallagher is 73. I've never heard of that name. Although I do love me the Gallaghers, but I've never heard of Rory, so there we go. That is probably gonna piss a lot of people off, because Rory is probably a legend. And I'm talking about the Gallagher douchebag, so do with that what you will. One way more famous than the other, so I'm just saying. Number 72 is Steve Morse. I've heard that name before. 71 is Jeff Loomis. 70 is Michael Angelo Bascia. I've heard that name too. Oh wow, 69, the butt of everyone's joke, Kerry King. I mean, Jeff Hanneman is just better, but it is funny that they give Kerry King the 69th position. I mean, yeah, get fucked, Kerry King. Get fucked, mate. Number 68 is George Lynch. Number 67 is Johnny Winter. Sounds like... let's not go there. Number 66, Alex Skolnick. I've heard that name too. Number 65 is Pete Townshend, of course, from the classic Who. You know, I love the Who. Yeah, just a great guitar. You know, the windmill move, classic. So yeah, you just gotta love Pete Townshend. Number 64 is Albert Lee. Number 63 is John McLaughlin. Number 62 is Chuck Schuldiner. Oh, and that's probably gonna be the thumbnail too, because I love Chuck. Great guitars. I'm really happy to see him on here. It's gonna get a bit more prog from this now on, because number 61 is Steve Howe, which is a great guy too. Guitarist of Yes, so gotta love that. 60 is John Lee Hooker, what a slut, or a prostitute. 59 is Sunhouse. 58 is Steve Lukather. 57 is Tom Morello, who of course had that high-pitched guitar sound. He invented that shit. I'm not sure how you call that, but he pretty much invented that style, you know, if you even want to go there. But Tom Morello, one of my favorites. Fucking hate his solo career. Tom Morello is an overrated hack, but I love his Rage days, you know, that's where he shines. So there we go. Number 56 is Lindsey Buckingham. I didn't even know that she played guitar. I believe she was one of the lead singers, but apparently she played it. And Stevie Nicks was, I believe, the lead singer, so do with what you will. I'm not really informed on Fleetwood Mac, because I'm just not the biggest fan, but you know, I still like I like rumors, but that's about it, honestly. 55 is BB King. Number 54 is Jerry Garcia. 53 Rick Nielsen. 52 Joe Wells. 51 Alan Holdsworth. 50 Dave Murray. Iron Maiden, of course. Really a middle of the road, honestly, because he is a great guitarist, but I don't think he is the greatest. I think I would rather prefer Adrian Smith, because he's more of a shredder, whereas Dave Murray is more of a rhythm, kind of laid back kind of guy, but sure. Number 49 is Alexio Laiho. What a ho. Number 48 is Joe Bonamassa. Number 47 is Eric Johnson. Number 46 is Jason Becker. I've heard a lot of these names, by the way, but I just can't quite put my finger on it. Number 45 is John Frusciante from Red Hot Chili Peppers. Arguably the most overrated hack in music. His solo career is god-awful. Just look at those needle drop ratings. I mean, come on now. Just a god-awful solo artist. He's alright in the Peppers, I guess. But, you know, people praising the shit out of him. Like, nah, mate. He just plays one or two notes. They're just so easy as fuck. You know, they have a lot of feel. And that's what... I'd rather have a John Frusciante than a fucking... than any prog metal artist, you know, well, not all of them, but you know, those, you know, like a djent guy or something. I'd rather have John Frusciante than a fucking djent guy, I suppose, outside of Meshuggah, so there we go. You get the point, you know, guys, I think that's more of a competition rather than an actual enjoyment. John Frusciante understands that, but he's still overrated as fuck, honestly. Number 44 is Chuck Berry. Number 43 is Yngwie Malmsteen, great guitarist too. Prog metal, power metal, I suppose, or just classical heavy metal, I suppose. Great debut album. He has kind of an iffy discography, but he is a pretty great guitarist, so check him definitely out. Check him definitely out, that's so weird to say. And definitely check him out, there we go. Then we have 42, Carlos Santana, Overrated Hack. 41, Michael Schenker. 40, Keith Richards, I believe he plays rhythm guitar, but apparently he is the greatest. Don't really agree with that, he's just really an overrated bloke, but if you want to put him on there, then, you know, you do you. Number 39 is Jeff Beck, a lot of people love this guy, I've heard his name, but I haven't really looked into him, honestly. 38 is Buckethead, yeah, I like Buckethead, but, you know, he has so many albums, I mean, come on now. Number 37 is Jerry Cantrell, one of my favorites, a lot of feel, a lot of... great licks that he has, a lot of diversity if you listen to Facelift and, you know, Dirt and self-titles, you know, the classic Alice era. He has a lot of diversity there, whereas in the later era he's more of a sludge kind of artist, kind of more sludge metal in a way, which I still like, but it's definitely way less exciting than what they used to do. But Jerry Cantrell is still one of my favorites. Kirk Hammett, 36, also one of my favorites, a great shredder, a lot of great diversity. Lord of the Wah pedal, and that was, I believe, the word that I was looking for with Tom Morello. But yeah, he has a Wah pedal, but he really, really has a delayed effect on it or something. I don't know what it is. Number 35 is Warren Hines, I've heard that name too. I've heard all of these names, by the way. 34, Mark Tremonti. 33 is Mark Morton. Number 32 is Django Reinhardt. Number 31 is Dickie Betts. 30 is Chet Atkins. Number 29 is Bill Gibbons. 28 is Eric Clapton, which is arguably the most overrated guitarist ever. Cream is good. Cream is a good band. I cannot deny that. The Layla album is... It's not my thing. Let's say it's not my thing. It's a classic. It's a cultural event, I suppose, but I just do not like that. I just do not like Eric Clapton, honestly. I'm just not a huge fan. He's not terrible, but he's just such an overrated act, honestly. Number 27 is Frank Zappa. A lot of great records in his discography. Great arts. I believe he played a shitload of instruments. Oh, and by the way, he played a shitload of instruments. So you better put fucking Prince on this list, or I'm gonna pull my fucking hair out. Number 26 is Vernon Ryan. Number 25 is George Harrison. Yeah, great guitars, although... Yeah, was he the guitarist of the band? I believe he played rhythm guitar, so I believe John Lennon played lead? I'm not sure who played lead, though. You know, I'm pretty sure that Canadian Stubman can say that to me, because he is the biggest Beatle fan ever. Like, I love the Beatles, but that guy is insane. Let me say that. This is disgraceful. Number 24, Buddy Guy. Not yet. Number 23 is Paul Gilbert. Number 22, Slash. Like, yeah, I guess Slash is more iconic than George Harrison, but George Harrison is a fucking Beatles member, and Slash is a fucking Guns member. Do you see what I'm trying to say here? Like, Slash is good, but he's not in the almost top 20 greatest guitars ever. Slash is pretty much the most overrated guitarist ever in arguably the most overrated band ever. Fuck's sake, mate. Overrated shit. He has some good licks, you know. He has some good solos. November Rain. That end solo is pretty good. The solo in Sweet Child is pretty good. Can I think of more? You know, I really fucking hate Guns, but Slash has his moments. Paradise City solo is pretty good. Even Alex kind of liked it, so that's saying something. Number 21 is Angus Young. Yeah, of course, puts Angus Young right beside Slash. That's, you know, sure that will do. Ooh, I really like this one. Number 20, Richie Blackmore. Huge fan of Deep Purple, huge fan of Rainbow. I love the shit out of Richie Blackmore. You know, he always wears that kind of witch kind of hat, and it always makes him look like a witch or a wizard in a way. I just love that look that he has. Highway Star, the riff on fucking Smoke on the Water, of course. Space Trucking, it's just that whole fucking machine at all. It's just fucking rocking, man. Love the shit out of Richie. Rainbow's Rising. Oh my god, that Stargazer solo. Richie Blackmore might be in my top 10 guitars ever. And that name too. Richie Blackmore. What a fucking name, man. I fucking love Richie Blackmore. Number 19 is James Hetfield. James Hetfield is probably the most consistent, the most diverse guitarist on the list. He has great licks, great solos, great look to him, you know. He has a great attitude. He has that ballsy kind of like, I'm going to beat the shit out of you attitude. But he also has a mature kind of held back kind of attitude. So he kind of has a split personality. I really love that about James. And he's a great guitarist too. And I'm actually surprised that he is like, he's like 20, almost 20 spots above Kirk Hammett, which is saying something. I love Kirk, but he has a little bit of too much wah in his guitar, where James Hetfield is just an all-around well-balanced guitarist, I have to say. So I prefer Richie Blackmore, but I can definitely see why James Hetfield is so high on the list. Number 18 is Zakk Wylde. I like Zakk Wylde. I like No More Tears, which is pretty much his peak performance. The No More Tears solo is incredible. I love that solo. But outside of that, he's not really that good, I would say. Like, he had that time when he was, like, shredding so hard that he was literally, like, bleeding his fingers out or something. Like, oh, look at me, I'm so passionate about what I'm doing. I'm bleeding out because of it. I wouldn't say, like, do that, because that's pretty painful, but he still did it, so good job. I would say Zakk really only has one amazing album, you know, No More Tears with Ozzy Osbourne. Outside of that, he doesn't really have a lot of great performances though. The follow-up to No More Tears, which, you know, was pretty underwhelming, but it's still pretty good. Osmosis, how's this song called again? The Legend of Something. Or maybe it was the title track, I don't know. There was a track on there where he was like sweet picking on a fucking Ozzy Osbourne record. I really like that, so that's good stuff too. I haven't listened to Ozzy Osbourne in a while, but I am a big fan of him, so there we go. Ooh, hell yeah. Number 17 is John Petrucci. Fuck's sake. Number 17 is John Petrucci. I don't know if I'm saying that right, but fuck it. Oh shit, I only have 2 minutes left, shit. Where's the fucking list? John Petrucci, one of my favorites. Yeah, I fuck up the name, I know. Great guitar, great diversity, he is an amazing guy, so I love him. Well, yeah, pretty much in my top 10 favorites, so there we go. Number 16 is Robert Johnson, a great, amazing 20s soul blues artist. Really influential, arguably the first guitarist ever, so you gotta love him. Number 15 is Dwayne Allman. 15 is Les Paul. The guy that they named after a fucking guitar, that's pretty good. He is pretty good. Number 13 is David Gilmour, arguably the guitarist with the most feel. I really love David Gilmour, he has a lot of feel in his guitar playing, you know, he just put it in his guitar. I love the guy, he's in my top 10 for sure. Yeah, David Gilmour, I would die for the guy. Dave Mustaine, number 12, pretty much the opposite of David Gilmour, still has some feel to it, but mostly shred. A lot of good shredder, a lot of good shreds on Dave Mustaine records, so I really love the shreds that he has. Number 11 is Randy Rhoads, which is a great mixer between the two. So I see why they put him above the two. To kind of say, hey, he has the shred and the fuel. So I see what they're doing here, but I prefer the other two. But Randy Rhoads is still a really great guitarist. Like, don't get me wrong, Zakk Wylde is pretty good, but Randy Rhoads just tops it, honestly. Number 10 is Steve Vai. Mike the Music Snob is a big fan of the guy, but every time when I look at his face, it looks like he's, or you know, he gets a blowjob and he's just he just got an orgasm from the blowjob. So that's how I see it. It's still pretty good, but you know, that face is just kind of too distracting for me. Number 9 is Don McDaryl, a legend, of course. Love Pantera. Don McDaryl is pretty much, you know, the reason why Pantera is a great band. So there we go. It's already 20 minutes, so I'm fucked now. I'm just gonna name them. Number 8, Stevie Ray Vaughan. Number 7, Tony Iommi. Pretty much a riff master. 6, Jimmy Page, pretty much the riff master in rock. Number 5, Joe Satriani. Number 4, Jimi Hendrix, pretty much a guitar god. Number 3, Alex Lifeson, which was way too high on the Rolling Stone list. Number 2, Brian May. And number 1, Eddie Van Halen, which was already showcased on the